माझं नाव सुनंदा पवन गवळी. मी कात्रज भारती विद्यापीठला राहते. माझी मुलगी डॉक्टर आहे. मला एक वर्षापासून राईट साईडला पेन व्हायला लागलेलं. टच करून देत नव्हतं. नाकाला, गालाला, डोळ्याला हवा पाणी लागलं की डोक्यातून क्रॅम्प्स येत होते. मग आम्ही बऱ्याच ठिकाणी माझ्या मुलीनं दाखवलं मला, बऱ्याच हॉस्पिटल्सना, पुण्यातले 7-8 डॉक्टर झाले. नंतर आयुर्वेदिक पण ट्रीटमेंट केली, नंतर होमिओपॅथीची पण केली. पण 5-6 महिने थोडंसं फरक होता. पण नंतर मग मला अजून खूप 2 जुलैपासून खूप म्हणजे क्रॅम्प्स यायला लागले डोक्यातून. आणि असं चालताना पण मला डोक्यातून कळा यायला लागल्या. मग माझ्या मुलीनं अजून सगळीकडं चौकशी केली, बघितलं. आणि मग ती एका हॉस्पिटलमध्ये काम करते, जॉब करते. तिथल्या सरांनी तिला ह्या इथल्या सरांचं नाव सांगितलं. मग ती एकटीच येऊन एकदा बघून गेली सगळं. त्याच्यानंतर मग अजून चालूच होतं. रोज ते मला दिवसातून 4-5 वेळा यायचं. चेहऱ्याला सूज आलेली, मला खूप त्रास होत होता. सगळं माझं शेड्यूल सगळं बिघडलेलं होतं. माझ्या तब्येतीचा सगळा परिणाम झालेला माझ्या घरावर. दसऱ्याच्या दिवशी मला खूप म्हणजे खूप त्रास झाला. मग माझी मुलगी येऊन गेली ह्या सरांना, इथल्या अमित ठाकूजी सरांना भेटून गेली. माझे मिस्टर, मुलगी, मुलगा सगळ्यांनी बघून मग आम्ही डिसिजन घेतला असं असं आहे MRI मध्ये, तर आपण करूया ऑपरेट. मग आम्ही इथं 2 तारखेला ऑपरेशन होणार म्हणून त्यांनी सांगितलं. टेस्ट करायला दिल्या. आम्ही मग 1 तारखेलाच इथं आलो आणि सगळ्या टेस्ट करायला दिलेल्या. आणि 2 तारखेला ऑपरेशन केलं, एकदम चांगलं सक्सेसफुल. आणि इथला सर तर 1 नंबरच आहेत. पण इथला स्टाफ पण खूप छान आहे, खूप सगळे कोऑपरेटिव्ह आहेत. आणि इथलं वातावरण, इथलं सगळी सिस्टीम खूप छान आहे. आणि मला आता बरं वाटतं आहे. आणि आज मला डिस्चार्ज दिला आहे त्यांनी. माझं ऑपरेशन खूप क्रिटिकल होतं आणि घाबरून मग मी 1 वर्ष थांबलेले. मग या सरांनी सहजरित्या ऑपरेशन केलं आणि चांगल्या पद्धतीनं केलं. आणि आज मी एकदम व्यवस्थित आहे. माझी फॅमिली, सर, त्यांच्यामुळं मला नवीन आयुष्य मिळालं.
माय नेम इज डॉक्टर नम्रता. आय एम द डॉटर ऑफ पेशंट मिसेस सुनंदा गवळी. माय मदर वॉज सफरिंग फ्रॉम माइल्ड सिम्टम्स लाईक माइल्ड हेडेक ऑन द राईट साईड. अँड ऑल्सो विथ इट स्टार्टेड विथ द फ्लिकरिंग ऑफ द आयज इन द मंथ ऑफ डिसेंबर 2022. वी हॅड कन्सल्टेड विथ ऑप्थॉल्मॉलॉजिस्ट अँड दे सेड दॅट द आयज आर ओके, बट वी कुड नॉट फाइंड आउट द वॉट वॉज द इशू. We thought it might be due to stress, but that was not the reason. The symptoms started to grow, and in the month of July, when it was very severe pain, she had cramps and swelling on the right side. We decided to get an MRI done, and in the MRI we found that it was a meningioma, or it could be a trigeminal schwannoma. So after that we started the treatment from the neurophysician. We got the medications, but he had also suggested that it might be required that you should get a surgery done. So I started doing some research on this topic and consulted a few neurosurgeons in Pune. But every time I would visit some or the other neurosurgeons, they would just say that it is a very critical surgery and that might be risky. So I was very scared, as she was my mother and I could not take the decision very firmly that let's go for the surgery. But the place where I work, so the sir over there, my senior, ही सजेस्टेड द नेम ऑफ डॉक्टर अमित धाकोजी सर ऍट मणिपाल हॉस्पिटल बानेर. ही सजेस्टेड दॅट आय शुड गो अँड व्हिजिट हिम अँड जस्ट गेट सम ॲडवाईस. सो वन फाईन डे आय व्हिजिटेड सर अँड आय आस्क्ड सेट वॉट शुड बी डन. सो ही सजेस्टेड दॅट रेडिओथेरपी कॅन बी अ सोल्युशन इफ यू डू नॉट विश टू गो फॉर द सर्जरी. बट अनादर थिंग ही ऑल्सो टोल्ड मी दॅट सर्जरी कॅन बी डन अँड इट इज पॉसिबल, यू जस्ट डोंट हॅव टू वरी अँड इट इज पॉसिबल. बट आय स्टील डीड नॉट फाईंड इट दॅट इझी टू टेक द डिसिजन फॉर माय मदर. सो वी कंटिन्यूड विथ सम आयुर्वेदिक ट्रीटमेंट ॲज वेल ॲज होमिओपॅथी अँड ऑल्सो द ॲलोपॅथिक मेडिकेशन्स वर गोईंग ऑन, बट द सिम्टम्स वुड नॉट सबसाईड. ऑन द डे ऑफ दशहरा शी सफर्ड with a lot of cramps on her right side. She could not even touch her face. It was very painful for us also to see her in that condition. So I decided to just visit Dr. Amit sir at Manipal Hospital again, and we just came. I came with my mother and my father, and we just asked that we don't know what to do, you just tell us. So he said that we should go for the surgery. So it was so in the emergency condition that we decided, okay, we felt that sir gave us that suggestion very confidently. So I felt that, okay, it can be done. So as soon as we met him, we decided that we will get the surgery done in the next week itself. And on 2nd of November, she underwent critical surgery, a neurosurgery. And we were like scared a lot, but it's due to Dr. Amit sir that she went through a very successful neurosurgery and the meningioma was removed. It was excised. It was also, there was some other also complication and that was also solved. After that, now she was admitted here for 3 to 4 days almost with all the very kind staff and helpful doctors. And all the staff over at Manipal Hospital, we are very grateful to all the team at this hospital that they have provided us best service. She is very fine now, she feels better, and today we are getting discharged. She is absolutely in a better condition. The pain has gone and now she is very healthy, and I am very thankful to the team at Manipal Hospital Baner, as well as Dr. Amit sir, his assistant teams, and all the staff members, the nursing, and also the housekeepers over here, the management team. Everybody was so supportive and cooperative. We are so thankful to them. Thank you.
Hello, myself Dr. Amit Dhakoji. I am a consultant neurosurgeon and head of the department at Manipal Hospital, Baner, Pune. So when I encountered this patient, Mrs. Sunanda Gavli, a middle-aged lady, around an year back, she had come to me with complaints of severe facial pain, and she was detected to have this small tumor around 2 into 2.5 centimeter near her small brain, or we call it as a cerebellopontine angle. So at that time she was quite concerned about the risks involved in surgery, and since the tumor size was small and she was kept on medicines, she wanted a conservative treatment. She was mother of a doctor herself, and then we had also advised two options, like surgical treatment as well as a radiation therapy to shrink the tumor. However, despite of taking lot of medicines, her pain in the face kept on increasing. She used to suffer from severe episodes of right facial pain, which was like electrifying sensations while chewing or while eating food, while brushing her teeth. So typically it is called as a trigeminal neuralgia kind of pain. She again came back to me around a month back, and because of severe pain, she urged for some form of treatment. So when I particularly looked at her again, I sensed that she has this refractory facial pain and it needs some kind of treatment. So again, the two options, like gamma knife radiotherapy or a radiosurgery and a conventional microsurgery, was recommended. However, the gamma knife treatment itself takes long time to take its action. Although it will shrink the tumor, we'll have to go ahead with repeated scans, and the pain may not have subsided so fast. So I told them the option of microsurgery, that's a complete excision of the tumor by doing a microsurgical resection and a small craniotomy behind the ear. So I explained to them the risks involved as well as the benefits of the surgery and the kind of setup we have here and the kind of monitoring we do for the facial nerve as well as the trigeminal nerve. And her daughter, being a doctor, easily understood all the possibilities and the benefits of surgery as well as the risks involved, and she consented for the surgery. So finally we went ahead with the surgery in the park bench position. We positioned her in the lateral position and then a small craniotomy was carried out, and using microscope and CUSA, the advanced techniques, intraoperative monitoring, I could remove the tumor completely. And my surprise, apart from the tumor, the nerve was actually sandwiched between the tumor tissue as well as a vascular loop of anterior inferior cerebellar artery, which is a normal cerebellar artery which courses near the nerve in the routine course. So after removal of the tumor, the arterial pulsations were actually irritating the root entry zone of the trigeminal nerve. So that was an important cause of a refractory facial pain. So this was a dual pathology case, and after removal of the tumor, I decompressed the nerve from the vessel and we put a Teflon patch in between the nerve and the vessel so that the nerve was completely free from the pulsations of the vessel. So this is a common condition called as trigeminal neuralgia because of the neurovascular conflict, that is the impact of pulsations of the vessel on the nerve root entry zone, which is a very sensitive zone for facial pain. And so this patient recovered remarkably well. The tumor also was completely removed as well as the pain disappeared, and we could also give her microvascular decompression in the same sitting as the tumor removal. So now she is completely pain free, and the good thing is that her medicines like Oxetol and Pregabalin also have been stopped completely, and she is completely off medicines. So this is the advantage of a microsurgery over the conventional radiosurgery, and retrospectively I feel that whatever decision we took for her proved to be very beneficial, as it relieved both the components and we need not follow her up so regularly as we would have followed up during radiosurgery. Thank you so much.